The Apple One was the first product of Apple Computer. It was Steve Wozniak wanted to build a. Steve Wozniak had a project to build a television keyboard combination for the people who were doing time sharing computing. They were trying to build a inexpensive time sharing terminal using a TV. So he built up his video circuit using some parts from Signetics actually for that purpose. And anyway, Steve was building this TV typewriter type circuit for that. And what he did was he realized when he had this working, he had a keyboard interface and he had a display, and he decided, well, if I have that, if I just take one of these new microprocessors that nowadays you can get onto that, I can hook it into that instead of hooking it over the phone line to the timesharing service. So that's basically what an Apple One is. It's a keyboard and a display system connected to a microprocessor. And it acts just like a dumb terminal in the sense that everything goes in through a stream and comes out through one stream, and that's all there is to it. So that's what an Apple One is. And what he built it as a single board computer. He used dynamic RAMs, which was unusual for the hobby computers of the day. And he put ROM code in it so that the basic that it would, or that that the operating system, which was not very much, could be reside on there, and then he could store the basic in ROM. And he added a little circuit which allowed him to interface to this with a cassette interface so that you could put on audio tape the programs. So he built that, and he showed that there was at the time there were a series of stores called Byte Shops, and what these Byte Shops did was they sold hobbyists the pieces to do computers. So they would sell the Altair computers and keyboards and all the pieces necessary to do that type of computing. And so the Byte Shop owner said, oh, well, I'd like to buy some from you. So he offered to buy, I think it was 100 of those. They said, well, sure, we can give you 100 boards. He says, no, I want them fully built. So I want them stuffed and everything. So they said, okay. So Steve Jobs went to one of the local parts suppliers and managed to talk them into advancing the funds to put the parts on here and sell them, because he had a contract to sell them to the Byte Shop, and they checked with the Byte Shop, and he said, yeah, well, I got an order for those. So he built these computers for Paul Terrell to sell in his Byte Shops. Paul Terrell had started one Byte Shop, and then he sort of franchised it out and opened a bunch of stores all around the valley. So there were probably 8 or 10 of them around in this area. So he bought these computers, and I saw one in one Byte Shop, and then I saw the one I bought was in a store down, actually pretty close to here in South San Jose. So all you got, though, is you got the bare board, you got the cassette interface, you paid a little more, and you had to buy a couple of transformers to make the power supply, because that's how it worked. And then you had to try to find a keyboard to work with it, and so you had to buy all these other pieces, too. So that's exactly what I did. I bought one of these boards, and of course at the time I didn't have all this nice fancy stuff around it. I've now taken the board, and I've now added to it, and this has been my hobby, is making the cases for this. This keyboard is a full custom keyboard that Brian and I that I designed, and then Brian helped me code the ASIC in it, and I did all this packaging, do all the woodwork, and it makes it into, and this is the display mode, because usually what you do with these is you demo them to somebody, right? That's about what they're good for nowadays, is to do demos. So you try to make, and you want to make it as presentable as possible, so that's why the real fancy molded, and it's not a molded case, it's actually bent plastic, believe it or not. That's what this is, and it all works pretty well. I can at least turn it on, and I don't know if you'd be able to. Maybe I can. Well, supposed to have an on switch on the front. There it goes. And I can turn it on. You can see that. Turn it on. You get a screen that looks like this, and all you can do is clear the screen, and then you can type. And all you can really do is get a character stream in and a character stream out, and that's it. And everything else is processed on the process on the thing. And you can, you can inspect space, and that's about the extent of the operating system. You just saw it. You can load tapes. They originally been intended for cassette tapes, but of course I worked on iPods, so I got to use an iPod instead of a tape machine. I mean, all they are a music player anyway. That's all the tape machine was. So why not use an iPod? And actually, I have this iPod set up. I think it'll work here. I have this iPod set up. I don't need any wires because I actually have a Bluetooth receiver inside here. So I actually Bluetooth. So it's kind of a crazy mix of old technology and new technology to make all this stuff work. It's just sort of an ironic, I don't know what you call it, superposition is that? I don't know what that is. But I think it might work, actually. See if it plays. Yep, it works. So it's talking, and I'm playing the sound through there. I hope I hit receive turn soon enough. And it takes a long time to load, but you get the idea of how these things sends a tone passage through and loads up. And this would, if this worked, it would load basic. I don't think I hit return soon enough, but maybe it worked. Anyway, that's how an Apple One works. And that's all there is to it. So I made a series of boards to go with it and things like that. But this is the Apple One. This is an original Apple One. Let's see. Okay, I'm in basic, so I could write a basic program. Okay, that was it. That's Woz signed this. It says, to Wendell, a most incredible engineer. And then it says, Apple wouldn't have happened without you. That was what Woz signed on it for me. So I got a signed copy. I didn't get Steve Jobs to sign it. That would have really been the coup de grace if I'd gotten Steve to sign it. But